Motown revisited Gaye's version less than a year later, when, as Berry Gordy recalls, the DJs played it so much off the album that we had to release it as a single. This older but newer version debuted on the Hot 100 in November 1968, and 4 weeks later, it reached the number one position, a spot that it held for 7 weeks. It became Motown's best-selling single ever. The vocal approaches of Knight and Gaye provide an interesting perspective on the gendered nature of soul singing. Gaye's performance evokes a distressed male outlook, connecting to the weeping trope exhibited by Levi Stubbs in many Four Tops singles from the mid-1960s. His strained voice nearly cracks several times as he reveals the manner in which he learned of his lost partner. Knight, on the other hand, uses a confident, full voice throughout her performance, belting the entire piece in an open-throated manner. In contrast to Gaye's vulnerability, Knight engages in a finger-wagging, aggressive threat when she sings lines like, "I'm just about to lose my mind." The mood of her performance, with its rhythmic drive, melodic language, and range, is far more self-assured than Gaye's approach, shading the text as confrontational instead of tragic. So here's Gaye's. You may have heard this before.